Mini chapter 78, the Platinum Raven's soundtrack comes alive. Jaymi lifts his attention out of his three beasts, leaving them attentive in their hidden observation post near the LA River. He'll be right back with them soon, but he is now growing more confident in his ability to dip in and out of the echelons he's working in. And he does still need to keep the Platinum Raven's creation cycle barreling forward, so he slides his laptop back along the bedroom terrace parapet towards him. Now that her visual art and soundtrack are both established, it is time to fuse the two. It's time to make her so transcendent of all the ugly smallness he can feel squirting out at him from every glyph and pixel of Ain't They Freaky, that the mere fact of her existence will cast a devastating light on the nature of Bangdead's wretched game and all its cultural and personal crimes. Opening the laptop, he is startled to see her pale brown desert eyes in close-up, almost filling the entire screen. They are overlaid with a chrome sheen, suggestive of a gleaming engine driven by the night in their depths. The rhythm of the revving of this engine is colossally barbaric within its visual polish and sophistication. Zooming out slowly, he reveals what's behind her. And it's not just any old backdrop. She's planted at the base of a vast dam, her feet a yard apart and her hands clasped behind her head, her eyes still fixed on Jaymi through his screen. He zooms further out in a panoramic view to show the dam's smooth concrete as tall as three cathedrals. From 1 mile back, she is now just a pinprick in the center of his screen, but she stares at him still from within her single pixel. In zooming back down towards her, he effects a transition in timescale, like the Ancient of Days wielding his dividers. So he lands at a point in her life that occurs after her game, The Platinum Raven, has ended, somewhere in that hidden future of hers that'll chance to be sung in no game at all. By now, through this fast-forward testing by Jaymi, she has risen to a worldwide fame that culminates here in a concert she's about to perform, seen by hundreds of millions, complete with a huge flame dancing up to lick the sky at stage left and stage right, the whole event powered by a wattage fit to melt an ice cap, plus a widescreen projection above the stage, fed from a camera that swings along beneath her. Her show constitutes a quintessence of triumphant energy, an authentic mass ecstasy, achieved jointly by her and by countless skilled technicians behind the scenes. Her music sells across the globe. Her art is worth a fortune. She stars in a blockbuster film every year, and everything she touches is gold. The Platinum Raven's unparalleled ascent and explosive apotheosis constitute the single instance of a human destiny whose cultural power is that of an atom bomb. Eyes wide at his laptop screen, Jaymi has become unaware of anything but her. Leaning forward within himself to see further and further into her depths, he feels vertiginous. With every new depth apprehended, he can make out a grander depth in her distance, then a still greater depth beyond. And he feels as if he's falling forward, down, ever down, snatched by her presence, out of time into eternity. Landing gently back on his bedroom terrace, he realizes that this feeling of falling forward into a revelation of her depths, as part of falling in love with her, is a platinum-tinted echo of the same feeling Kim had when he looked into Shigem while Jaymi was test-driving the pair of them. And a glow spreads through him.